Every automated workflow you create needs rules to follow. With multi-step Zaps, you can add lots of rules to build smarter automated workflows. One type you can add is a filter to make sure your Zaps are performing actions only on the items you want. By default, a Zap fires every time it finds new information that matches your trigger. But when you insert a filter step, you're adding an extra condition. Your Zap will only continue running if your data matches certain criteria. Think of filters like traffic lights. You wouldn't want traffic in the street running all the time, so stop signs and red lights exist to control the flow of traffic. Filters also control the flow of traffic. It gives the green light to data that meets certain rules and puts up the red light for everything else. Filters are optional, so you don't always need them for Zaps. But when you're getting too much information and need something more specific, filters are your traffic controllers. Let's say you want to create a Zap where a message gets pushed to a Slack channel whenever you get a new lead in Salesforce. But you're getting too many messages. You decide that a qualified lead is someone who signs up for one of your campaigns. Well, you can create a Zap with a filter step to act only on those leads. Just select the field you want your filter to check and the conditions, or the logic your filter will use. Now your Zap isn't running every time you get a new lead. It will only run when a qualified lead comes in. And your team is now saving time. A few things to know about setting up a filter. You can add a filter at any point in your Zap once you've added a trigger. And you can have multiple filters in a single Zap. Zapier can check for a specific field and a number of conditions. You can add multiple conditions if you'd like to. And you can choose whether you want all the conditions to be true or either one. So to recap, filter steps are traffic lights for your data. They only allow your Zap to run if the information coming in meets certain criteria, and you can add as many conditions and filters as you like. Play around with filter steps and see how they teach your Zap to work smarter. We'll see you in the next lesson.